Hello, everybody. This is Woolrig, and welcome to episode 5 of Agrarian Skies. So, I had a bit of a mishap here. While smelting some lead, I accidentally placed this block on the ground. I went to put it in the chest here with these other ones, and I placed it. The problem is, I don't have a pick right now that can mine this. So, let's see what I can do to make one. Fortunately, I think I have an idea. I believe that if I make a steel pickaxe head, so we see here it says parts can be replaced. So that's one of the nice things with iguana tweaks for Tinker's Construct, is that it allows you to interchange some of the parts of the tool without having to build a whole new tool. So if I make a steel pickaxe head, I will get a mining level of diamond and a pretty reasonable durability. To get steel, I need to have molten steel. Seems kind of strange. Fortunately, there is a quest that talks about steel-powered flight. And I need to get the steelworking and you, which is this book right here. And I can see that this can be crafted by taking some seared stone and pouring it over materials in you book or just a regular book. And that will get me that. The seared stone, I have exactly 8 millibuckets of it, and that is just from smelting a single block of cobblestone gives me seared stone. So if I take materials in you, wrong version, I realize that. This is the red one. This needs to go in with this one. What is this? Volume 1? Is that volume 2? Is that what that is? Must be. Oh well. I've done Tinker's Construct so many times, I can't tell you the last time I looked at the book. Okay. Oh, there it goes. And now we have steelworking and you. Excellent. That gets me. I think I want Eulorium. That gets me a successful quest. And now we can make the high oven. So while the smeltery sits here and does its thing, there is essentially the next tier of Tinker's Construct, which involves the high oven, and this allows me to make steel, which is going to be pretty slick. So high oven requires all of these similar pieces. So let's take a look at what it'll take to make the scorched bricks. I take regular brick, I put seared stone over top of it, and I get scorched brick. Let's see, I've got a handful of these already. Ooh. A good reward bag. What does that give me? Ah, a redstone clock. Cool. That is gonna be handy. I kind of modified the smeltery. Added another level on there, so that gets me, 9 more spots in there. And then I did also add another outlet with another drain, and I'm using a casting basin, which allows me to cast entire blocks rather than one ingot at a time. So, just makes it go a little bit quicker. So let's see about... First off, you know what? I need to make another crafting bench. And I'm going to make this one legless. And put it over here, next to my smeltery, because I like to have one. Okay, so I know I need to make, what is it, a controller, a drain, scorched brick, and a duct. Alright, so a lot of this is made very, very much like the smeltery pieces. So there's that guy, there is that guy, and the duct is like that, but I am out of what I need. So let's take a look at this. What is it? One of those, so that's one cobblestone per 8 millibuckets. That's fine. And some brick. So I need clay to make bricks. I have clay. That shouldn't be a big deal. I have some clay that I want to break down. Because if I smelt it, or if I cook it up like in the full brick, that will give me a full brick instead of the individual bricks. So, let that cook up. How's this guy doing? I've been making lots of lava because that is what feeds my engine over here. Alright, in the meantime, while that's while the bricks are cooking up over here, I did manage to finish making some raw plastic, and when I put it in a 3x3 grid like that, or 2x2 grid like that, that allows me to complete a quest. Getting rubber. I want that one. And oh yeah, I killed a bunch of zombies. Let's take a look at that reward bag. Ah, nice. Glasses, that's cool. Those are going to come in handy because I could actually kind of break those down to make... I think I can break those down to make different colored dyes. Let's go ahead and finish out my other chest up here. Hey, it's raining out. Cool. Hasn't done that in like forever. Alright. My inventory. I'm trying to keep things organized as best I can. But yeah, my inventory is getting a bit chaotic. Let's see. Apples. Don't need those in here right now. The timer is going to come in handy here eventually. Not so much right now. Cool. That should be enough to get me started. Except I need some more cobblestone. So let me get some cobblestone here and come back in a bit. There we go. I made everything. And I can craft graveyard soil, so I'm not really going to worry about that too much, but the scorched bricks will really speed up the process if I can just do these on my own. Oh, right. That guy needs steam. Steam machine. What do we got? Ooh, seeds. Seeds are good. Seeds are good for future planting endeavors. I'm gonna put those away for now. More heart pieces. Where's my book? So let's look at this steelworking book. And in here, it talks about the construction and some of the different things. Basically, you need a controller, a combination of bricks, a drain, a duct, and a faucet. And the high oven looks something like that. So a 3x3x3 is the simplest one with a hollow center. Yeah, so the controller must have an active redstone signal to burn fuel. Simply place a lever anywhere next to it, and it will do the trick. should only be fueled with charcoal or other specialized purified fuels, which do not create unwanted residue within the chamber. Yeah. There is all of these modifiers then too, so, you know, oxidizers. You need to have an oxidizer. You need to have a reducer and a purifier. So, yeah. It's not just... So, essentially, here's how you make steel. Gunpowder, redstone, and sand. Charcoal, iron. That all becomes steel. I can make pig iron. I can make nether quartz. That's interesting. I can make scorched bricks. There's ways to do that. You know, lots of different ways. The deep tank is something I can work on down the road. Block of gunpowder, huh? Are those my fuels? So the, I think there's a quest for the tank. So when I'm working with the smeltery, you'll notice I'm making alloys. When I get, like when I made the aluminum brass, that was an alloy of copper and aluminum. So you have to be careful when you're using the smeltery, because depending on certain materials will actually mix and create an alloy. You don't have that problem with the high oven. It will not mix and create alloys. And when you want to store stuff, you can store it in a deep tank. That's one way to store the molten liquids. Not my preferred method, but just one way. So let's create a faucet, lastly. Alright, so let's get this guy put together. I want to make a lever. Piece of cobblestone. The nice thing is that the high oven uses charcoal, which I can get from wood, as opposed to burning up all of my lava, which right now is still kind of an expensive thing for me to try and create. So I've got two buckets of lava sitting there waiting. I think this guy's pretty well... Yeah, he's got about two buckets also. So what I want to do is place like that, I think. And then we'll come around the edges and create the 3x3 with the scorched brick. Except I want to open... spot. So I want to keep the center place open, and that spot that I just opened up there, let's see, I need a drain. Drain will work. I need more pieces. Controller goes over here. I thought I had enough. Apparently not. Let me see what I've... I think I had a few more bricks left. I had two more. I don't think that's enough. Interesting. I need one more. Actually, you know what I can do? I can do this. I'm not going to use it, but I can put it there. And that should, ta-da, complete my oven. And I put this here. And now I need to, because I only have one spot in the middle there, I can only make, basically can only make one brick at a time. Or one, steel ingot at a time. So I need the rest of the materials. Let me sleep to get rid of this rain. Didn't have any rain for how long, and now suddenly it's raining all the time. Alright, I need sand, which means I'm going to bust down some gravel. I need charcoal there. I need redstone. I've gotten some of that and gunpowder. Okay. So that should just about get me everything I need to make some steel. Fortunately, right now for this this pickaxe head, I only need a single piece of steel. So we're going to put some sand in there, redstone, gunpowder, iron, and charcoal. Now the trick here is that this isn't going to do anything until the oven gets up to temperature, and so that's why there's this on-off switch, because that tells it to start cooking the charcoal. And I don't remember how much I need. There's a certain temperature requirement to be able to essentially make the steel. And once you get the oven up to temperature, it will work faster. But then once you turn it off, it starts to cool down. So it's kind of this balance that you've got to manage the temperature of the oven, basically. Oxidizers, reducers, and purifiers. Except I have this in the wrong order. I think you can do multiples at a once, if I remember right. It's been a while since I've actually used the high oven, so I generally don't use it. Not because I don't like it, it's just, it's kind of complicated. You know, there's a lot of going on here, so I just generally find other ways to make steel. Unfortunately, there really is no other way right now, so this is it. Stick the faucet on there, and you can mix and match these. There is a where is it? There is a seared faucet, which I can use seared bricks, and there is a what is that? A casting table. I think there's one using seared bricks. Yeah. Same with the basin. I don't have to do all of that, though. I can use the casting table and the faucet from the smeltery. So just using the scorched bricks instead of the seared bricks. So this is going to cook for a while. I'm going to let this cook for a while and come back, hopefully, when we've got some steel. All right. Should be just about there. Maybe. So the temperature's rising quite high. Yeah, I don't remember, like I said, I don't remember the temperature, the ideal temperature for steel, but yeah, we'll kind of see where it goes. I think it might. Is it complaining because I don't? Oh, there it goes. It made one ingot of steel. And so what you'll see is that because the temperature is up, this will actually start to go up quicker. And if you'll notice, it didn't use all of the materials there, so it's not like a straight one-to-one on this, which is nice. Yeah, see, now that I've reached the appropriate temperature, it's going to start processing this a lot faster. I just need to make sure I keep the heat on it and keep enough resources in there to essentially purify the iron and make steel out of it. But what I can do now is take the pickaxe head casting, place it there, and make a steel pickaxe head. Cool. Which I can use here in just a minute. I want to make sure that I get the rest of this iron all cooked up. I mean, if I'm going to go through the effort, I might as well. Might as well do it. That was all of the loose iron. I don't want to break up a block to do that just yet. So I can actually take the heat off of here. So if I take that charcoal out, it'll essentially finish cooking the one that's in there. And when it gets done, then it should continue to operate, but it'll start to cool down. So I'm going to go ahead and let this all finish up making the rest of these. I think I had 9 total ingots in there, so I'm going to let that finish and come back in a second. No, second thought. I'll just let that ride. So, let me stock up the sand here. Because I really don't need to sit here and watch it. It's working, it's doing its thing. What I can do is turn that off, and that should... this should continue to operate, but it won't cook anymore. So if I put charcoal in here, it wouldn't cook anymore. Because there's still one burning, it's going to finish burning that, and then it's going to start to cool down. So, yeah, even in the off position. It still runs. Okay, so this pickaxe, I need to first repair the one I have. Because it has to be fully repaired before you can place any parts in it. Fortunately, this one just takes wood to repair. So I got it fully repaired. I come in here, and just like when I repair it, I do that, and now I have a steel pickaxe head, mining level diamond. And it's really that simple. The nice thing is that all of my levels and everything that I've gotten from using this pick, they all persist. So that's, you know, that's nice. I don't have to make a new tool and level it up. I can just use the existing one. How's this guy looking? Looks pretty good. So that's going to continue to heat up. Oh, there we go. It finished cooking, and you can see it cools off pretty rapidly, which is fine. One of the things that the book talks about is that you can put water into the high oven here, and basically you pump water in into the tank, and it will output steam. And then I can use that steam to generate power. We might try that a little bit, but not right now. Right now, I have a whole bunch of molten nickel in here, and I have a basin that is not quite full. So I didn't have 9 ingots worth of, I believe that's lead. So I've put, I think there's like 8 ingots worth of lead in here. Not 9. So it hasn't finished the block. So I want to dump all my nickel in there, but the lead is in the way. So I want to get rid of that. And there's a quest that will help us. I need to make a fluid duct and a pneumatic servo. The fluid duct is pretty easy. It's just copper and lead. Nothing fancy there. I'm just making the opaque one. So copper. And we'll break that lead block apart. 2 pieces of copper, 1 piece of lead. Should get me a handful of those. And then I need some other stuff. I need some glass. I think I have a few pieces of glass. So the other thing I'm going to need to make in here is a pneumatic servo. So I need two pieces of glass, iron or silver or Invar or alloy, steel, aluminum. I think I'll go with the iron. And a piece of redstone. Okay. I should have everything I need. Except I turned all my iron into steel. That's fine. Alright, that one, those two, and there's a complete quest. Huzzah! So, okay, I can move the fluid, but what else can I do with it? Well, if I scroll down to my quest lines here, there should be... where is... for the hoarding? No. Oh, go with the flow. There we go. Fluid storage. So, different tanks. Let's look at what it takes to make a portable tank. So my basic portable tank is copper surrounded by glass. Excellent. I have copper. And I have glass. I just don't have any with me. One of these days we'll get our storage all straightened out. It's a little crazy right now. Sorry. There is that. One of the tools I'm going to want to make is a crescent hammer, I think. So that's tin, iron, tin and iron. So let me see what I've got for tin. Perfect. That ought to do. Let's put away some other things. A bucket. That. These things. A basic reward bag. Cool. Corn. 20 corn. Alright. I've got iron. I need to make tin. So that is... I don't... I think I want to mix tin and nickel, though. I could be wrong. What can I mix those with? So iron and nickel makes Invar. That's good. That's it. Okay, cool. So I can mix tin. I can mix tin and nickel and not have any ill side effects. So let's go ahead and... dump out the rest of these. Ooh! Where's that clock? Watch this. I got a clock from... there it is. I'm going to make a lever. This clock is going to be really handy for this. So we'll make a lever. Grab the clock. And drop down here. So if I put the clock here, it starts sending a clock tick. I think every 1 second, it sends a pulse. Which is pretty cool, because as long as I keep taking the ingots out, it will keep pouring them until it's completely done. Pretty handy. If I put a lever on it, I can stop it, and I can start it. And at some point, it should be done. Yep. Cool. So I will do the same thing over here. Probably need to make another cast, but for now, this will work. And actually, I'm just going to go and pour one piece of tin. Because that's all I need. So those, that, and that gets me a crescent hammer. This is important because it's going to allow me to move the portable tank. Because, yeah, the tank is portable. So I'll put that in there. Grab my servo. Servo goes in there. I'm going to disable that. Oh, wait. I have to hit this. So there's the output. There we go. That pulled it out and should have gone into there. It did not. Okay, why didn't it do that? There it goes. Oh, right, the portable tanks you can only fill from the top or the bottom, not the sides. So now that's empty. I can pop that off and come back over here, grab this, and pour it out. Cool. Well, let me get all this nickel out of here and be right back. All right, I got everything cleaned out of the smeltery so I can make some alloy now. And I'm going to make some Invar alloy by mixing two ingots. Let's see, that'll give me, was that three? So each ingot is 144 millibuckets. So that will give me, I believe, three is what that comes out to, which is perfect because I need two. So I need to put in two ingots of iron and one ingot of nickel or ferrous. So put one in, one there, those two, and let that cook up. And you can put the, these drains can work in two directions. So the lead is not a major issue, but I could pump it back in if I wanted to. I don't really want to, so I will hit that twice to disconnect it, and I could put the pneumatic servo in to pull the lead out, but these tanks will automatically output if you just click it. And so it is feeding down into there, filling up the ingots. And I can should see that I've got molten lead in the pipe still. Should be just about, yeah, there's my three ingots of Invar. I'll get this lead cleaned out. And we will make some Invar here shortly. This should be the last one. How is there? Wait, what? There's not. That's kind of funny. There's an odd amount of lead. Oh well. You know what? I'm just gonna scrap that. So I'm gonna break this. I lost that little bit of lead that I had there, but that's fine. I'm not too particular about that. We'll get all of this put back together. Oops. And make our Invar. Invar for the win. Alright, then I need a piece of iron, because I am going to make the autonomous activator. I've got the pneumatic servo. Let's go ahead and make another one of those. Right, that should be, yes. Well, I realize I'm going to need some more sand, because I need to make some more glass. And it'll just be one more piece of glass. Right. Yes. Alright, we're gonna grab two of those. I need to grab some wood and some cobblestone. That's not enough. Let's go try out these steel pickaxe on the cobblestone back here. Oh yeah, much faster. Cool. That's enough. All right. That one, this one, that one. All right. We need to first make a piston and see if I can not screw this up. Hey, I did it right. I'll go ahead and just use the servo I've got, make another one later. Realize I'm running a little long on time. Apologies. But I want to get this done. Make a chest. One chest, one of those, one of those, one of those, and voila, I have an autonomous activator. Now, what can I do with this guy? I've got an idea. He can help me out immensely. So the autonomous activator is a very nice little box that basically it can do two things. It can right click and it can left click. It can aim up and down, and that's about it. So I'm gonna take this and wrong direction. Turn it around. So I turn it around with the crescent hammer. So that's why one of the reasons I wanted to make a crescent hammer. Make life easy. So by default, it is set to right click. This is the older version of thermal expansion, so the autonomous activator does not require any power, which is pretty handy. Okay, so I'm going to do a little bit of prep work here. Oops. That's fine, that's fine. Yeah, okay. I am missing some wood. Shoot. I thought I had it all. Need to make a second chest. I've got one. I need to make one more. And then I need to make a standard hopper. And I'm just about there. I think I want to grab. I've got a couple other picks here. That one, no thank you. This one is cactus. This one's a netherrack. I have no way to repair it. So, at least not yet, anyway. So, I'll just use the one I've got. All right, let's put this here. Let's put the hopper down there. So the hopper should be feeding into the chest. So now, if I break this, it ends up in there. Perfect. And another one comes in. So I'm going to change some settings. I'm going to flip this over to here. And you can see that it's hitting it. So it's breaking this cobblestone, and once it breaks, it's going to disappear because, if I hit it with my hand, cobblestone disappears. I want to turn off the round robin, use first slot only, and then I'm going to put that in. So now it's using my pick and leveling it up. Forgot I did that. And essentially automated cobblestone. It's still pretty rudimentary, but hey, look at me. I don't have to stand there and break cobblestone. So that is going to help out hugely. And I can switch out the pick for a hammer. And now instead of cobblestone, get gravel. So, yeah, that is automation on an order that I can appreciate. Cool. Well, I'm gonna wrap up now. So this is Wolverig. Thanks for watching. Leave me a comment. Let me know what you think. Give me a thumbs up. Tell me what you think of the series so far. I think it's going along pretty well. I've got big plans. Big plans. Anyway, thanks for watching, and I will see you next time. Bye-bye.